Reynders, the floor is yours.
Thank you. I want just to say some words about two issues. The first one is the Council's yearly rule of law dialogue, and the other one is the discussion about the way to tackle anti-Semitism in the European Union. And today, of course, after the publication of the annual rule of law report on the 30th of September, we have had the first discussion on country-specific chapters in such an annual report. We have had a first discussion, a general one, in October, thanks to the German presidency, and now we have discussed about five member states, like it was explained by Michael Roth. And it's true that I have recalled, together with Michael Roth, some years ago in 2016, to have such a kind of dialogue. And now it's a reality, it's a key achievement. It marks an important milestone for our work to strengthen the rule of law in the European Union. And at this occasion, I would like to, again, to thank the German presidency, because we have discussed about the rule of law in all the different meetings of the Geneva Council since the beginning of the presidency. And not so long ago, it was still hard to imagine having long and very enriching debates on the rule of law, similar to the ones we have for budgetary situations, for instance. And today, the picture has completely changed. Together, the EU institutions have made it possible to have a permanent debate on the rule of law in the EU altogether. And we debate about five member states, and our objective was to ensure a dialogue based on the principle of objectivity, non-discrimination, and equal treatment of member states. It was also important to conduct this exercise in a preventive manner, which helps to preclude challenges from emerging or deepening and allows to share good practices. And it was the case because we have discussed, to give an example, about digitalization of the justice system on the basis of good examples, like this one is Estonia. And there's a real intention of the member states to organize a good collaboration on this in the near future, and the Commission will come with a communication on digitalization of justice in the beginning of December. Among others, of course, we have discussed other kind of judicial reforms, information and communication technologies used in courts, I said, but also efficient framework for accountability of judges and for disciplinary measures, the independence of media regulatory authorities to help protect media pluralism, national anti-corruption strategies, checks and balances, and other kind of issues. And the five member states concerned then had the opportunity to present their views, followed by other member states who could comment, including by explaining their own experiences and best practices. And the goal is to exchange those best practices. And it's the real intention to have a better understanding of the situation in all the member states and to debate collectively on this. And the exchange of 2 days were very constructive and allow member states to do that, to exchange best practices. And we should continue building on this achievement. And for the future, we will continue to work with the next presidencies, the Portuguese presidency, the Slovenian presidency next year, and then the others, in the same way, with a peer review on some member states, and with a possibility, of course, also to discuss on the second annual report on the rule of law, because we are starting now the preparation of our second rule of law report with the intention to present such a report during the Slovenian presidency. And I want to thank the next presidency for their commitment to continue the work start by the German presidency. Of course, we are also trying to organize the same debate at the national level in the national parliament, and thanks to the German presidency, it was possible to organize a first debate in the Bundestag in Germany, but we have had also a debate with the Danish parliament, and I'm committed to go to all the national parliaments to explain the situation, to discuss on the rule of law, and to try to install a real culture of the rule of law in the entire European Union. So thanks again for the German presidency for such an opportunity. And just some words to say that we have had also a discussion on tackling anti-Semitism. Sadly, we have seen in recent years a rise in hate speech and violent attacks motivated by extremist ideologies directed at Jewish community. The coronavirus pandemic has been accompanied by a wave of disinformation and anti-Semitic acts. As we have seen in Halle, Paris, and Hanoi, the road from conspiracy myths to hate crime is short. Together with UNESCO, Twitter, and the World Jewish Congress, the Commission is implementing the hashtag Think Before Sharing campaign to combat online conspiracy theories, including based on antisemitism, and to complement member states' efforts in adopting and implementing national strategies against antisemitism. The Commission will table a strategy against antisemitism in 2021. On 18 September, we already presented an ambitious anti-racism action plan, which aims to turn the tide against all types of racism, including also the fight against hate speech online. And the Commission will also adopt an overarching strategy on the application of the Charter of Fundamental Rights in early December. In addition, we are currently reflecting on how to better mainstream the fight against antisemitism across policy areas and look forward to the declaration currently negotiated by the German EU presidency. The upcoming Digital Services Act will ensure at the beginning of December greater transparency on how platforms moderate content on advertising and on algorithmic processes. The Code of Conduct on illegal hate speech online also remains crucial to fight online hate speech. It has been a success story since it offered quick improvement while fully respecting fundamental rights and the right of freedom of expression. We are already working hard to ensure that European institutions, member states, businesses, Jewish organizations can join forces. Collectively, we need to ensure that Jewish people can live their lives safely in the European Union without being victims of terrorist attacks, hate crimes, and hate speech. And there is, of course, a link between the two issues, the possibility to defend our values through the rule of law, and of course, to fight against antisemitism. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Commissioner.